Welcome to the podcast, guys. It's the 28th of October. It's a Thursday. We're back in business. We've refreshed the whole soundboard, and there's only one thing I can say to that.
Up the raw.
Yes! We got it upgraded.
Will you fuck up too?
But we've also got some old classics in there. Isn't that right?
What happened?
I think it's just so sensitive. It's a brand new Rodecaster. Yeah. You know, because the last one shit its pants and I would badmouth them, but the guy from Rode messaged me and we might be able to hook something up. So you know what? Your product, when it's brand new, is the best on the meerkat, is it not? Truth bomb. Today's podcast, is sponsored by our OG sponsors. As usual, they've locked on and they won't let us go. And that's manscaped.com. And of course, the emphasis this month is on gifting. Christmas is coming up. You're going to want to get someone that package. What do they call it? The fucking crop duster ball bag package or something? You buy the whole thing. The lawnmower 4.0 is in there. It is the world's leading depuber on the market. Is it not?
Yep.
Is that loud?
Wee bit.
It needs to be loud because we're going to talk over. We're talking about serious issues here. Shaving your nuts for Christmas. Do you know what? They've sort of taken the issue out of your hands. You want to get a meal, a present for Christmas. You want to get them a quality product where they're like, oh shit, this is slightly fucking unexpected from you. Get them the fucking Manscaped package. They've got the whole thing in there. They've got the plow, you can shave your face. You got the manscaper, the lawnmower, you can shave your nuts. They got the other one, the weed whacker, goes up your nose, in your ear, or in any other hairy circular hole. Ball toner, ball deodorant, actual aftershave. It's all in there. And if you listen to this podcast, you can go to the website and enter the code GenBant1. GenBant1 to get 20% off. And these are high quality products, you know, they're not giving them away. So 20% is quite substantial over at manscaped.com. You know, they got the tools for your family jewels. And that's just, I just made that up. That should be their slogan. I'm joking. Truth bomb. GemManscaped.com, shout out to those guys. And our second sponsor, once again, beer52.com. The world's leading beer subscription service. You hit them up. You fucking get beer sent to your house. I didn't know you can get 8, 10, or 12. That's an option.
Oh.
You can up the dosage. So if you want 12 brought to the house, you can make it 12. Listeners to this podcast, if you use the code BANTER at the website, you get the first box free. Order yourself 12 beers, get it for free, pay for the postage, and you can enjoy a selection of hand-picked IPAs and weird stouts. And it's coming up to Christmas, so God knows what they've got up their sleeves. Pumpkin spice dipper? Tippa? Triple IPAs? It's good stuff, man. I complained before that they weren't sending me any stuff, and now my house, I'm tripping over beers in my house. Can't drink them fast enough. So shout out to beer52.com. Use the code BANTER to get the first box free. And then you don't even have to make any effort. Every month after that, they'll just sling one out to your house. It's absolutely crazy. We'll get into this podcast, will we?
Up the raw.
The General Banter Podcast with Colin Geddis.
Bam. Now, I don't know where to start this week, to be honest. Last week, our baby was teething. Straight into the boring dad shit here. The baby was teething. He had fucking fangs coming in the back there. And he was sleeping like absolute shit. And I was busy, you know. Lavery's was going flat out. I was gigging all over the place. And I picked up a cold that's knocking around. And I felt it come in on the Sunday. Went and trained very hard in the gym. Well, of course, you know, the messages come through the soundboard now. Deafening. And it's my da. Happy birthday, forgot. Yeah, so it was very busy. Picked up a bit of a cold at the weekend, last weekend. And then went in and trained like I'm doing the CrossFit Games 2022 on the Monday. Felt a bit shitty. Did we even get a podcast out that day? Did we get a podcast out last week? Or did we skip it? Did we?
Yeah.
Yeah, we did. And then I was just like, I don't feel great. Lavery's came around, I was like, sounded real fucking snotty and got the feel like I've got the cold. And, you know, being a typical man, it never dawned on me till like way later on that I could just take a night off. Like, I was trying to work around it, like, get me the Sudafed, I'll blast it up my fucking nose here, I'll take all this shit, no one speak to me, he'll save my voice and all. And then Maureen was like, you should probably just not go if you're sick. And I went, oh yeah! Sometimes people take a day off. Also, it sounded horrific. You know, sometimes you can be like shaking off a cold or something and you sound okay, but I literally sounded pretty sick. Like, every time I spoke, people were like, all right, man. So, had a bit of a week off there. But in the interim there was a lot of action, okay? I'd spoken to a few people, Aaron McCann being one of them, okay? We had booked this live podcast, which is happening this Saturday, which is pretty much sold out at this point. There's about 8 tickets left. And I got talking to him and I was like, oh man, it's a shame you can't come home. And he goes, oh, it would be class. I'm just trying to see what, you know, if this workplace will, like, you know, give me the day off. I've already asked for some leave. And I was like, fair enough. And then he was complaining about the boss being a bit of a B word. Bitch. And, you know, I was like, you know, what are they paying you a month there? And he told me, and I was like, you know what I mean? You can come home, do a live podcast, do a couple of laveries. You know, you could probably make that monthly pay in a couple of nights doing gigs. And he goes, fuck, sure, I might leave, you know? And me being very encouraging and sensible, I was like, get out the fuck. Get out the fuck. You'll get yourself a job anywhere else. Come on home for the podcast. So he's like, I'll think about it. And I was like, no sweat. And I was just at home trying to get better, because that weekend I had Galway Comedy Festival coming up, which was quite a big deal. You know, I was put on some very big lineups alongside some big comedians. You know, first night I was on with fucking Andrew Maxwell, my new best mate. You know, guy wouldn't leave me alone. Fucking walking across the hotel, he's like, Geddis! Geddis! Yes, lad! Chatting to me and all, do you watch football? No. You know, Ed Byrne was on the first night too. You know, he wasn't as friendly, but sure, what can you do? You know, Andrew Maxwell was very friendly. Ed Byrne was like, fuck off, you fucking scumbag. And, you know, because that generation of comedians, you know, no harm to either of these two guys, dweebs. That's truth bomb. That was the way, you know, a lot of dweebs knocking out. As, you know, comedy got more and more popular, different types of people started doing it, including people like me, who've maybe done a deadlift or lifted a box, you know, not these fucking librarians, but, you know, I think he was a wee bit like, you know, fuck this guy. Fuck this, you know, guy thinks he's, he got me all wrong though. He was like, you know, oh, guys look like you and all vaping. And I was like, I don't vape, you fucking pussy. Anyway, I was on big lineups, big deal. And, you know, did some late shows. I'll talk you through the weekend. I landed and thought I was going to enjoy one of Galway's many eateries, and in fact I was late for the gig, so I just went straight to the gig. And that first gig, I'm glad you didn't come down the Friday now. Died on my arse.
Oh no.
Died on my arse hole. But then so did everybody. Nobody really did. It was in a function room in a hotel. And I went to, Carl Spain was MC, and he did I mean, let's face it, he absolutely dropped me in the shit before I went on, because he did two fucking pretty racist jokes. Like, there was a couple there, and he's like, oh, where are you from? And they're like, Iran. And they were working in Boston Scientific, you know? So they're obviously very smart scientists. And he was like, oh, what's the deal with the masks? You know, is that a corona thing or Muslims? And I'm standing behind the curtain going, well, this has got my work cut out for me here. Oh, hello. And my sister just came in there. Truth bomb, can't hear that. So, where was I? Oh yeah, this is actually what he said. He goes, oh, is that fucking, is that corona stuff or Muslims? And I'm behind the curtain sweating bullets. And then he made some sort of because they work in Boston Scientific, he's like, oh, is this Boston, he made like a Boston bomb joke.
Oh dear.
And I went on after and I was just like, hey guys, And they have to use your own mic because of Corona. So I took the new mic and I was like, oh, had to change the mics there. I don't think this one's racist. Now that got a laugh. That got one laugh. That was the one laugh I got in 20 minutes. The rest of it was like, see when people maybe are thinking about stand-up and they're like, man, what happens if you just get up there and there's loads of people and all the stuff that you've written just doesn't get any laughs at all? I'm like, it still happens 11 years in, because it actually happened there and then. People were just miserable. Like, he'd fucking dug a bit of a hole, and then they were literally just sitting in the front row like this. And I was just saying things at them. Terrific. And then I come off and I was like, sorry guys, that was absolutely terrible. And then of course, you know, all the big famous comedians, Shappy, Corsandi, you know, they're all standing there like, oh well, you'll get them next time, big shooter, enjoy the fucking death. Then she went up, didn't get a whole lot. No one did really well. Like, I was standing in the back of the room. I was like, no one's killing here. So it made me feel slightly better. And then we went down and did the late show, which was very interesting. You missed that night too, didn't you? What day did you come down?
Sunday.
Fuck me. So you get to the late show. It starts at fucking 11 o'clock. Shout out to our girl, Shappy, there. She had a few pints in her. And she was doing a few bits and she was like, oh, this is really nice. And then she's like feeling herself. And then she's done like an extra 10, 15 minutes. So she'd been on half an hour. Tom the Bear, who's at the side, you know, friend of the show, Tom O'Mahony, with his fucking mullet. He's got a mullet and he's going bald. You know what I mean? Business at the front, party at the back, retirement home in the middle. But he sees her doing running over a bit and he's like, it's my show now. It's my turn. I'm going to run over a bit. And he went up and he did about 15 minutes of stuff that was pure fire. Did about Tiger King and everything. Just absolutely killing it. And then at a certain point, I seen like, you know, 8 pints of Smithwick's hit his legs. And he did. He just ran into steam and he was just fucking taking swings at anybody then. There happened to be a girl wearing a hat. He's like, look at this fucking hipster bitch with a hat. And then that went on, and then there was a break, and then I thought I was going on, and then they introduced this Scottish dude, and then I was still waiting, and then I went on at 1 a.m. But thank God it was good. And then, you know, I think I said to you earlier, I had about twice the whole weekend. 2 bits of food, and the rest of it I was just eating Smithwick's with a spoon. And then the night you came down, I was gigging. Your mate Fitzy was at my gig, was he?
Yeah.
Did he have any thoughts on it? I thought it went well.
He loved it.
Yeah. I needed that actually. You know, felt good that night. Big crowd. Couldn't get in the building, mind you. You know what I mean? Walking up like, hi, I'm on tonight. And they're like, are you sure? It's like, yeah. Had to walk me around the side. It was very embarrassing. And then who else was on that night? Maxwell was on. Glenn Wool. And we met Reginald D. Hunter. That was an experience. Just an insight into many, many decades on the road with that guy. Came in the side and he kicked the fucking fire door through. He's like, what's up, baby? Fist bumping everybody. And then a dude handed him like a Tesco bag with a bottle in it. And I jokingly was like, is that Buckfast? And he's like, shit, that ain't Buckfast. I don't drink that shit. And then he actually said something like, the only time I would drink that is if a bitch I was fucking on was drinking it. I was like, okay. I don't drink that shit. But if I'm having sex with a woman who happens to be drinking Buckfast, I'll maybe go along with it for a second in order to get the sex in. And I was like, very cool, bro. And the bottle was actually just Smirnoff, which he drank out of like a children's party cup. Like he was drinking fucking, you know, Ribena. Outrageous. But it's weird, the festival, isn't it? Because, you know, I'd gigged with him and then when we met you later in the bar, he's just chatting to you.
I know, yeah.
How long you been in the game, man?
Well, Reggie, funny you should mention it.
It was so fucking bizarre. And then, yeah, the next day I was like, am I fuck staying for this final gig? Now, that was a lovely weekend. Had a great time. Then when I got back, I was chatting to Aaron McCann further and I was like, are you leaving this job or what to come do this podcast? And he's like, fucking right I will, sir.
Up the
rock. Fucking right I will, right? And I was like, brilliant. get the flights booked. He's booked the flights. He's like, I'll stay up in Belfast for the gig, and then I'll go home and see them more. Then we can do Laveries on the Wednesday, Thursday. Now, this is all just a load of shit talk to get us to this point this morning, right? First thing in the morning, I get a message from Arma Khan. Sir. Sir. Fucking fuming. Or no, sorry, wrong message. Sir. I've woke up today, can't taste a thing. And then 10 upside down smiley emojis.
Oh dear.
Now, the guy does live in London where they're just absolutely acting like there never was Corona. Even when we went over to fucking Leicester Square Theatre, do you remember? I was amazed when I got off the plane. I was like, oh shit. These guys are fully going at it today. Fucking thousands of people in the street. But I think we ring him. Will we ring him?
Ring him.
I'll see if I can, if he's hooked up to the blue teeth. He is indeed. He won't answer. He's probably on a tube. Knowing him, he'll say something mental like, oh, sir, I'm away to get a PCR test, but before I do that, you know, I'm going to a rap battle. Or something. Like, I'm doing some super spreader type shit here real quick. He's not going to answer, is he? The guy never has credit on his phone.
Oh.
Hello?
Wagwan!
Wagwan.
Here, can you hear me all right? I have you hooked up to the fucking Bluetooth on the Rodecaster. You're live! On the podcast.
What's the crack, sir?
Here, not much. We're just laughing at the state of everything.
Oh God, don't even chat to me. All I can think about walking to this PCR test center is, you know, that Kevin Hart bit where he's like, I got the bead.
Yep. How do you feel?
That's literally all going to my brain right now. I feel totally sweet. That's the thing. But right. Like, literally woke up today, made myself a bagel, and was half crying into it, being like, for the love of fuck, please let me taste a scrambled egg. And I'm just like, I can't taste shit, can't smell shit, so I'm going to get this here now. I've taken two lateral flows, though, this morning alone, and yeah, they're both sweet, so I don't know a fuck. But you know whenever you're, like, dosed,
yeah,
and like you've properly flued up, but like if you blow your nose hard enough, you can taste for like a second whatever the fuck you're eating. I'm not getting that. So that's what's making me go, oh fuck, this could be a thing.
You see, I don't know, because I've never lost my sense of taste ever.
Mm-hmm.
And I actually don't even know if that would stop me eating. But so you also, the thing that pissed me off the most about that was the way you said bagel, but you got to go into this test center and be like, I can't even taste my bagel.
For the love of fuck, set me right.
Are you getting on 15 tubes to get to this COVID test center?
No, it's a walk. It's
super spread McCann. Ladies and gentlemen, can I get your attention, please? I've got COVID. Stop the train.
Let me off.
Stop the train, let me off. Oh, that's hilarious. So, like, I mean, not that hilarious. What happens if you go and get this proper test? When do they let you know if it's clear or not?
They will let you know literally this evening.
This evening? So, yeah. Your flight is supposed to be tomorrow?
Yeah.
What time?
Like 9 a.m.
Oh, Christ, on a bike. Tense. I tell you what, they should be making a documentary about the next fucking 12 hours. That's very exciting. What happens if you...
Well, it's not going to be that exciting. It's just going to be me getting a fucking PCR. Then I'm going to go home, eat something else, have a wine, and sleep until I get my results.
I love the way you're like, you know, possibly your life is in balance. And you're like, here, let me eat again and get a wine again.
Sorry. I subscribe to the Stoic philosophy. So,
oh, you do?
There's nothing to be done here.
Oh, yeah. What did Marcus Aurelius say about cranking one out before you fucking die of a virus?
Crank that COVID, boy. Crank. Get it out of you. I think it was Marcus Aurelius said, get the badness out of you.
Get the badness out of you. Have a bagel. That is fucking hilarious. You know, you're being fucking death row and they're like, what would you like for your final meal? And you're like, 2 wanks and look is it. Thank you. What happens if you've had 2 negative lateral flows and then you go for this test and you're like, you're negative, and then they're just like, oh yeah, you can't taste anything. What happens then?
I don't know, sir, but as long as this hair comes back negative, I feel like I'm good to go, but I wouldn't mind getting my fucking test back.
In fairness, you know, a bagel with a scrambled egg in it isn't exactly a fucking explosion in your mouth.
Well, maybe the problem is, maybe I don't even have COVID. Maybe I just suffer from classic white seasoning, which is just salt.
You got the Caucasian COVID. You just don't have fucking salt and pepper in your fucking eggs. Imagine going into like a test center and being like, I've lost my sense of taste. And they're like, what happened? You're like, well, I was eating porridge with water in it. I couldn't really taste.
You're just white as shit.
Yeah. Man, I was just eating rice crackers and I couldn't fucking taste the thing. Man, I was eating fucking mass biscuits or whatever.
I'm not getting 1 iota of flavour out of this cheese string here. I think I've got it.
I have a low fat baby bell here. I can't taste any. Have I got COVID?
Oh, fucking hell, man. I'm probably super spread right now. I just fucking laugh from the street.
What the fuck is that? Are you at a motocross event?
I had to take my mind off it somehow, for fuck's sake.
Tim was right. You will go to anything. You will go to any event. Have a night off, sir. You want to go and see quad bike racing in the O2? There's some idol beside McCann at a fucking bus stop here just getting COVID splats to the face. Oh my god.
Oh fuck.
I wonder because you're double vaxxed, can you like get COVID a wee bit and get a few things from it, but not even test positive for it?
Well, that's why I'm wondering. Also, what is the crack if you're double vaxxed and you do get it? Are you still like super contagious? Or, do you know what I mean?
Well, I think so. You can still be a carrier, always, I think. You can carry it on anything, your hands or your fucking whatever. As far as I know. But
well, I'm just outside the gas here now, so I'll I'll go fucking be half sick here for about a couple of minutes and then pop back out.
Go get it and we'll find out later. Tension. We'll see what happens.
Oh, God.
Well, here, fingers
right,
crossed.
No worries, lads.
Because I've just sorted this podcast for Saturday, so we'll see. Fingers crossed. See what the crack is.
All right, lads. All right.
Take care. See you in a bit. Bye. Oh, fucking hell. At least he's in good tune.
Yeah.
You know, if he's got the cove. Although it would seem like, you know, he did do 2 lateral flows.
I know.
You know? You know, you think like, you think if you really had it, you know, something would pop up. But then, is it only for antibodies or something? I don't know. I still don't know the fucking crack with it, like, to be honest. But it was well worth phoning him there because he's fucking aged anyway.
Yeah.
Good crack, like. Might be dead by the weekend, but it's all good. Oh, my bastard. Tell you what else happened, folks. My birthday. 35.
Woo.
What age are you now? 29 soon?
29 soon.
What's your
27th
of November, yeah. 35, man. You can sort of get away with it for a while, and then you're like, I'm 35 now. Gotta really sort the shit out here. Gotta sort some shit out around these. Gotta go to the gym. Gotta, you know, when people offer you shots, you gotta be like, no thanks. I'm all good. You know what I'm like with the old thing, everything. 35. Man, you're just reflecting back on my... I've done some stuff. You know, I've done some good stuff, haven't I?
Yeah.
I've accomplished some... I've done a lot more than most people. Tell you, they're rocking on, you know what I mean?
Up the rock.
You know? But yeah, it seems to be like a weird reflective age. You're like 35. Okay, let's fucking... Let's see what we got going on here. Where do we want to go? You know when you speak to like a 22-year-old, you're like, what's your five-year plan? And they're like, what? Fucking and beer. That's my plan. But you hit 35 and you're like, all right, do you want, you know, when you're 40, do you want to be able to be like, turn around and say you've done whatever or got whatever? And this is why when people are like, man, are you going to do any more Blender videos? I'm like, no, I'm 35, man. I'm an old, old man now. What about you? Like, I'm not going to be doing that. The side of a shed. I'm 35. I'm an old, sexy older man.
Will you fuck up, dude?
Strange. But I was trying to write a bit of material about it. Was I talking about this last week? I was just like, you know, the 35 thing is like, doesn't really matter when you've looked like you're 42 since you were 16. Do that maths, you know? What's it like being 35? Well, you could have asked me that when I was 14. just the same shit, you know what I mean? You get served in the office, no bother at all. And fucking, you know, fucking bouncers let you in everywhere. And you fucking, you buy an old car. Buy an old fucking Vauxhall for good money. Because I'm 35 right now. But you know, it's, you're getting, you know, you're in the like dad age now. Because absolutely fuck all happened for my birthday, you know. I was like, I'm in Galway. I'm going to come home early to see my family on my birthday. I'd rather see them than be stuck in a hotel room. And then I come home and it was like, oh, I should have stayed. Everybody's sick. No one gives a fuck that I'm here or gone or whatever. It's all, you know, it's all good. No, but it was nice that we had a little, Maureen's sister actually made a cake. Said Colin on it.
It's, oh, wow.
Fucking tasty. It was like one of the, you know, proper like, you know, like, multicolored sprinkles birthday cake that you would see in like a Katy Perry video that you'd have over both of her tits. It was like one of those, like one slice and you're like, argh! It was great times. Gift wise, I bought myself a watch and now bought me an AeroPress, shout out.
Oh yeah,
gonna have four coffees in a row after this. Will I do a William O'Hall and like just find the most obscure place that I can have a coffee?
Yeah,
you know, here I am on the wing of a moving plane. Can't have a wee coffee. How does he get the hot water? Flask? Okay, I just solved my own problem. Nice. Or does he heat it up in the wee fire thing?
Oh yeah.
Does he?
A wee stove.
Fucking lunatic. Yeah. I would just have the coffee at the bottom of the mountain. Stay there.
In a shop.
Yeah, in a shop that someone's give to me, you know, in a cup. Does coffee taste better in a paper cup? Real talk. I think it does and I don't know why.
Yes.
I feel like, you know, we bought like a big stack of paper cups for the house. I can't stop making coffee in a paper cup. There's something about it. Something about it, man. 35-year-old fat bitch.
I'm about to bust a move.
Bernie Mac there, shout out. We got some questions. There was a couple of other things I wanted to watch. Obviously, one of the hot talking points of the week there was our boy Rishi Sunak. Was in there doing the old budget. Did you see that?
No.
And he's fucking upping the price of alcohol and all that shit. The man is walking about in the fucking thing. Bear with. He's walking around in this room doing all his sums and whatnot. Man's wearing a pair of Palm Angels slides, bruh.
Boom.
And everybody's like, give me back my fucking money, you bastard. Look at him. He definitely says Wagwan and the, you know, Wagwan, boys. So yeah, He's all out here fucking stealing everybody's. It's not even that they're 95 quid. It's that they're like sort of hot streetwear.
I know.
Do you know, like, yeah. Why does he have them? Does he have sons or something? Or is he just a real OG, triple OG? Now, how is he not? Like, he's like a fucking Steve Coogan character, isn't he? You should retrain in a different thing. He looks like Stephen Mangan or whatever his name is, doesn't he? I'm getting real racist here. Yeah.
Oh, he does, yeah.
Rishi Sunak. Now, could Stephen Mangan do brown face if he played him in a movie? Is what I'm saying. Yeah, I think when you're in a in a position like that and you're like responsible for fucking taxes and things like that, you know, are you allowed to really flex like that? Obviously you are, but it's like, man, have a bit of decency. Although maybe he wasn't expecting to be photographed in his fucking slides walking around the house. It's hard to know, like. Rishi! Everyone hated him after that arts comment. You know, I think all artists should retrain in a different fucking thing. And me and Mickey talked about it at the time. We were like, I absolutely agree with him. Because some people are asking for money for some real shite out there. Especially when it comes to the performing arts. Listen, if it's not music, and it's popular that people enjoy, or comedy, get the fuck out of here. Plays? Eat my ass. Musicals? Get a knife and fork and eat my ass. In fact, go out, get a gun license, buy a gun, buy cartridges, blow my brains out. If you're talking about a musical. And that's at the highest level. See when it trickles down and people are like, our local place is doing, you know, they bought the rights to fucking some fucking, what do you call the dude? What do you call the famous music guy?
Andrew Lloyd Webber.
Yeah, what the fuck was I going to say? I don't know what I was going to say there. I was going to just say it's fucking four random names. You know, they bought the rights to some bullshit and they're like, do you want to come to Kickstein to see fucking like Evita or something? Did I make that up? That's not even his. That's just, what does he do? Do you want to come to fucking Kickstarter? Let me see. Let me, for the purpose of the joke, Andrew Lloyd Webber. He was DJing there at the weekend. I said, look at the guy's face, man.
Boom.
Man is swolled up. Look at that guy. That guy is a Bo Selector mask.
Wealth.
Unmasked. Wealth, yeah. He's got that face. You're like, I mean, me like it. Come on, man. I was eating caviar out of a young boy's veins. And it was delicious. Brr. Have you ever heard Patton Oswalt's B-word fat?
No.
Bit? He's like, I want to get so fat. It's called B-word fat, where everything sounds like it's got a B on it. He's like, I bought the bracelet at Berkeley, Berkeley. What's he got? Evita? Did I pull that out of my ass?
Boom.
We need the button. Where is it? No. Yeah. Man, I am culture. That's the name of this podcast. I am culture. Have you seen many musicals?
Me? No. I actually haven't.
No. I mean, we went to see Wicked. Maureen wanted to see it in London, and I was like, can you drink at it? And she's like, yeah. And I was like, okay, then. And we went to see it, and I was like, a lot going on here. Very impressive set. Of tits. No, very, very impressive set. And then after it, I was like, it was good. It was a bit of a spectacle, a bit long, a bit wordy. But I was like, it didn't make any sense to me. I don't know what the fuck was going on. She goes, well, have you seen, what would it be before that? Wizard of Oz?
Yeah.
And I went, no. And she goes, oh, well then, fucking idiot. Of course it doesn't make any sense. And I was like, how dare you? I didn't know how to do fucking homework. Joseph and his Mexican colored dream coat. Phantom of the Opera, Love Never Dies, Cats, Dogs, Sunset Boulevard, Jesus Christ Superstar, Evita, School of Rock. Man, this guy must be making some major till. Net worth. $50 billion. I'm absolutely rolling in it. Now, 820 mil. Do you know who has that sort of money? Larry David as well.
Does he?
Yeah.
Up the raw.
Know what I mean? Loaded. Fucking loaded, bruh. But that's showbiz for you, man. I don't know how I got onto that. I wanted to watch. Someone sent me this and they were like, could you react to this? So here's me watching this for the first time. Look at my search history there. Vomit noise, spelt it wrong. Wiggles, pause, deadlift. Dylan Osborne, Colin Geddis. That's because I was watching that vlog he made when we were getting the photo shoot pre-lockdown.
Yeah.
And now we're getting to use the artwork and this asshole has COVID.
Will you fuck up, too?
People are going to get real sick of that, but it's all good. They wanted me to react.
I'm gonna be a comedian, so you never.
What the fuck?
The struggles.
Whatever. Shut the fuck up. The infamous Island Boys. You've seen these this video going around the internet, have you not?
Yes.
Island Boys. I'm an island boy. Now these two fucking gimps. This sort of went viral. These two guys are just singing in a pool. Oh Christ, here's a fucking ad for some horse shit. What about me googling vomit noise and there was an ad for Audible before it? Do you enjoy noises? Do you enjoy audiobooks? You're gonna enjoy the noise of this man yakking. Now look at these fucking roots here.
I'm an island boy and I've been trying to make. Oh, I'm an island boy.
First of all, do you know what kills me? Look at the anticipation on the guy on the right waiting for his turn.
And I've been trying to make. Oh, I'm an island boy.
He went to go. Was like, so awkward. That makes me laugh so much.
I'm a just island boy. I'm a just island boy. Ooh. I'm a get key one.
Do you ever wake up in the morning and you're like, do you know what? I'm a just island boy.
All the time.
You gonna have breakfast? Ah, I'm just gonna island boy. I'm a just island boy. Whiter than me.
You're gonna keep that gun. I'll be just staring at the.
This guy's coming in his pants at the side. Wait here.
You're gonna keep that gun. I'll be just staring.
Do you hear him? I'ma just get that gun. He's like,
You're gonna keep that gun. I'll be just staring at the sign. I'm just out of full gaze.
No rhythm at all. One of them's going like this. The other one's going slower. And then he's just going. I'm just island boy.
And I'm like, pull where I'm staying. They're like, you wanna be fine. You're gonna keep that gun. I'll be just staring at the sun. I'm just full gazing. I'm like, pull where I'm staying. They're like, you wanna be famous. I'm trying to be out the greatest. I'm gonna float all boy.
Run out of breath.
I got real damn tropic, I'm like the dumb on the topic, I'm an island boy, I put my vest on, yeah, like a wagwan man, try to make it to the top, I'm an island boy, I've been trying to make.
Where's Andrew Lloyd Webber when you need him? I've noticed the Island Boys, and I think we could have Island Boy the Musical. You're going to be played by one of the banjos from Diversity. And we'll simply stitch a bunch of dildos into his head. And he'll just come straight out there and be like, I'm an island boy. Just the worst rapping and timing of all. You know what it's like?
I'ma just say some things in a pool. I put a vest on sometimes. Maybe put socks on Tuesday. Watch television sometimes. Maybe not. With a gang swing, you ain't just swing no kind. And through the storm, through the rain, cause we try home like.
The panic in his eyes is incredible. They're just darting around like, what am I gonna say next, please?
I'm from the island boy, from the Caribbean.
You're from the Caribbean, I believe.
Okay, you're so cool, yeah. I'm an island boy, put my vest on, yeah. Like,
not worth it. What do you think of that? What's your breakdown of that? Mentally ill or
very
yes?
Good.
Very good. absolute man's man's got bars. Fucking metal bars of the face, hopefully. They have actual songs though.
I got actual songs.
Are they brothers? I mean, these two fucking ball bags just like backing each other up all day.
I got a song called Island Boy, and then he's like,
sounds good, man. Are they just eating ass there? Are they just eating two asses? Are they?
I got tampon hair. Let me eat your ass.
Imagine putting the call out for that video.
We're looking for two fat bitches. Gonna eat your ass. We don't have payment. We'll buy you a sandwich.
Imagine, like, just two dudes eating stinks, like. And I know we're gonna get taken off fucking YouTube for it. We gotta cut this bit out, but like, I mean.
Fucking man. Fuck your man.
Fuck your man. Fuck your man.
It's a way, it's a way.
Now the dog has won me over.
It's a wicked twist of mind, that's a wicked way. It's a wicked way. We be larking, we be purging, purging, purging. Ha ha, we be purging. We keep going out of the wicked way. Play it down, send it all down, it's a twisted day. Play it on a nigga with a stick, it's gon' really spray. Keep it on a nigga like we keep it like a fadeaway. Do it on a nigga, but that nigga never get.
Dropping a lot of N-bombs for two white guys, like. It's very sad. But they, you know, what I like is that they opened with them just eating two girls' asses, and then they never really revisit that yet. You know?
Mm.
You know, you think if you got them for the day. You know?
Do you want to eat the ass? And they're like, do you want to get some cutaways? And they're like, nah. I've already ate that ass. I'll probably just leave it at that.
I don't know. Do you want to get her dancing on the table?
Nah. I already ate her anus.
Well, how weird is that? Like, that's the opening shot. Just eating two booties. Maybe they're doing it themselves. Who knows? Anyway, real cool, guys. We'll hit some questions, will we? Dave Chappelle was all over the place there. Have you seen this video?
Oh, this new thing?
Yeah, it's like a clip that he put up sort of being like, am I cancelled or not? Of course not.
No.
Of course he's not cancelled. Do you know what I mean? Like, the proof that you can't cancel him is that Netflix stuck on his side. Do you know, they're basically going like, what's worth more to us? Us have owning his shit and putting it up here, or being on the side of, you know, trans people and trans allies that are like upset right now. And they're like, hey, we'll take Dave Chappelle, thanks.
It's been said in the press that I was invited to speak to the transgender employees at Netflix, and I refuse. That is not true. If they had invited me.
By the way, I seen the video of this, right? Of that gig where I think Joe Rogan was on this show too. And it was like all these acts on this, you know, on the running order. And then it just said Joe, Dave at the end. And because it was Joe Rogan was like opening up. So this looked like the fucking Super Bowl. There was probably 80,000 people at this fucking place. And if, of course, Joe Rogan's bringing him on. So he's like, ladies and gentlemen, you know, doing that screaming voice. The great, powerful Dave Chappelle. And he walked from the back of the fucking arena like it was a fight with about 15 people around him the whole way up to the fucking the stage. Like, very cool. Very cool. But like, how can you still be sitting there? Oh, how am I cancelled? You're like, bro, there's a fucking, look at the size of the crowd here.
I would have accepted it. Although,
if that was all your fans in the world, you could still work forever.
I am confused about what we're speaking about.
Now, if I do stand up for two more years, can I get a denim jacket that says G on it or C?
I
could wear that one.
Boy, you could.
G on the other side. Colin!
How could I not? You said you want a safe working environment at Netflix. Well, it seems like I'm the only one that can't go to the office anymore.
Oh. Oh. Wouldn't say no to a pair of them shoes, though.
I want everyone in this audience to know that it, even though the media frames this, that it's me versus that community, that it's not what it is.
I'm basically waiting for the Hannah Gadsby bit here.
Do not blame the LGBTQ community for any of this shit. This has nothing to do with them. It's about corporate interests and what I can say and what I cannot say.
Did you hear Carl Spain's joke at the weekend there? He's like, when you identify as a TV sandwich something.
Oh, yeah.
The LGTV BLT something.
Yeah.
For the record, and I need you to know this, everyone I know from that community has been nothing but loving and supporting. So I don't know what all this nonsense is about. In summer 2020, when the whole world shut down, I was outside doing shows. My neighbor had a cornfield and he let me throw shows there, and people came from all over the country. Some people came from around the world.
Look, shut up, I'm trying to get to the fucking...
And with this controversy, movie studio, not a film festival, nobody will touch this film. Thank God for Tess Randall's and Netflix. He's the only one that didn't cancel.
By the way, this is like the closer of a show that you've paid in to see.
Yeah.
I'd be like, do some fucking jokes, yeah. Dave. He probably sits down in the morning. He's like, what epic shit can I say at the end of this set here?
To the transgender community, I am more than willing to give you an audience, but you will not summon me. I am not bending to anybody's demands.
It's easy to say when you're about 500 mil.
And if you want to meet with me, I'd be more than willing to, but I have some conditions.
People are standing up there.
First of all,
like it's church.
You cannot come if you have not watched my special from beginning to end.
Nothing in that cup, Dave. Stop.
You must come to a place of my choosing and a time of my choosing. And thirdly, you must admit that Hannah Gadsby is not funny.
That's a bit I wanted to hear. I wish I had a timestamp that, to be honest. Hannah Gadsby isn't funny. Did you hear the whole... There was a lot of people kicking off whenever she first put out that Nanette thing.
Yeah.
Do you remember that shit? And it was like, you know, she was very pro. She's like, you know, you know, comedy, these things have to have more of a message. It has to be about, like, what are you saying over the fact that it's funny? And every comedian on earth was like, shut up, you fucking weirdo. And then, of course, people's automatic thing was to just be like, this isn't funny. And I watched it trying to be like, you know, sometimes when there's a general sweeping opinion, I'll be like, right, I don't know whether people are just going along with this or they actually feel strongly about this. So I put it on, like, oh, I'll give it a go. And I mean, sure enough, it was like fucking cutting teeth. Is that a saying? it was like pulling teeth. That's what I'm trying to say. Jesus Christ, it was rough, like, but what can you do? But I am sick to death of Dave Chappelle playing this kind of, like, feel sorry for me card. He makes fuck you money, so I would just be saying fuck you quite a lot to everybody. Even if there's like a million people cancel him, he's probably got fucking 50 million that still would fucking go see him and buy his shit. It's very strange. And he did that with the Chappelle show where he just banged on about it for so long. I went to Africa, did all this shit. And you're like, yeah, but it turned out fine, Dave. And you did 6 specials. And then the last one, you just got pissed off because you made trans jokes. And then people got pissed off at you. And then you're like, don't be pissed off at me because I just like trans people. And then went on about it for an hour. It's a strange scenario. Quite literally, I'm just like, Dave, someone fire up a GH5 at the back of the Comedy Store and just film you doing an hour and a half. That's all I want to see. Doesn't have to be flashy. Just show me the goddamn comedy. And then he does a podcast and sells it. The audacity. Anyway, we had some fucking questions here. How long have we chatted for there now?
50.
Fuck me. There will be one podcast this week. We're going to line up some guests for next week and churn them out. But there was a bit of sickness and a bit of travel going on there. So you know what I mean? Can't make excuses, but there was two genuine excuses there. Let's get through it. On a scale of 1 to 10, how steaming are you and McCann going to be at the live podcast? Well, if he's not dropped dead, I dare say we'll have a beer. And then, I mean, where do you hear this? Where do you hear this for beautiful? I think Shane is going to go see Mickey's show at the Ulster Hall. And what happened last time at the Ulster Hall was a Mickey show. They shut the building pretty quick. So we were taken out the back and transported to the Limelight where we had some drinks. I'll be in the Limelight, hopefully with Aaron. Fingers crossed he doesn't die. And then he will, you know, they'll come across the road and then we'll just be like fucking beers in the air, you know, like in a movie. Clink. Steamboats. And then Maureen will probably be driving and she'll be like, right, this isn't fair that I can't get steaming, let's go. And then we'll have to go home. But for that brief minute, it's going to be glorious. Currently suffering with the cold / flu. Any suggestions, old wives' tales to shift it? Shout out to Giles, by the way. This guy designs kitchens, or bathrooms, sorry.
Nice.
And he sent me a bathroom thing, and I will get back to you. I just haven't fucking... Basically, what I have to do, there's a process. You get it. I show my wife. We argue about it for about 2 days. We fall out, don't speak to each other. And then 2 weeks later, we go, well, we get this bathroom done. And then we revisit the drawings that you sent us. Thank you very much, Charles. old wives' tales to shift it. I'm a big believer in, first of all, loads of water. Get some vitamin C and vitamin D and chug that shit. Lots of hot drinks. You know, loads, keep your body warm, loads of that shit. And then just blast the fucking, that's pseudo. There is no more effective drug in the world than Sudafed. Have you ever used that when you just shoot it up your nose and it just clears everything? You still sound like you've got the cold, but you're not fucking snots tripping you. So it's the shit, and then just loads of fucking lem sips and warm shit. Don't do what I do, which was think that if I got in a hot bath that it would make me feel better, and then I just actually felt like I had a fucking temperature for the next 8 hours. So don't do that. but yeah. Thoughts on a video of Paul Scholes sucking his 20-year-old daughter's toes? sometimes I'm like... Is that Paul Scholes though? Paul Scholes' daughter, Alicia, posted this on her Instagram stories. These class of 92 are weird. So yeah, I don't know what's going on there, but it looks like he's biting her toenails. But it's like, when the fuck would you ever do that to anybody? You know?
Yeah.
If someone was like, will you bite my toenails and then you can just fucking rail me from the back in a sexual way, you'd be like, no. Let's cut to the railing from behind. Yeah, that's fucking weird as shit. You mean you'd have to have, your feet would need to be in good nick to be biting someone's toenails. Now, why did I feel like I feel sick now. Danny, getting more beanies back in stock? Yes, we are, by the 100 load. You looking to do a similar 12 pods of Christmas this year? Give yourself a break. If so, what guests would you be keen on getting? I think it's unbelievable when you can pull it off, the 12 pods of Christmas. But what was it not like? It was fucking tough. Like, literally might have to start now.
Yeah.
You know, like starting.
Oh yeah,
like start to go. Like, who would you want to chat to? and start filtering like one extra one in a week. Wouldn't you? Like, that's how you would have to do it. It's fucking tough. What I will say is, like, for Patreon people, there was a big spike in numbers when we did that, because that is a lot of content to be, like, dumping out there. Sometimes if there's one, like, that's really good, and you're talking to someone who's got a lot of information, or it's even helpful, maybe a few months later we will put that out, and I hope no one really gets too pissed off about that. You know, because sometimes it's like you do want more people to hear the thing because it's valuable, basically. So yeah, I might start making a bit of a short list and see if I can. The problem is, though, remember last year, it's everything after the recording. So obviously it's going on Patreon, so you want people over there. So you have to go, here's each episode. Here's a clip from each episode. Here's an audio snippet to go on iTunes to pull people over, and then you schedule all of those one per day, and then it's like a full shift, like. But maybe we just figure out a more streamlined way to do it, get more people to fucking help out or something. But who should we get on? What sort of ideas have we got floating about? I'll do a post in the Patreon and be like, who should we get for 12 pods? Same question. Also,
will you fuck up, Tate?
Would you ever come back to do a gig in Derry? Yes, I would. Basically, what has happened at the minute is there's been a lockdown, if you recall, and normally I would do a tour sort of in the winter. So at the minute, I'm just kind of cherry picking gigs that I can go do. What the average person on the street might not know is the availability in a lot of places is terrible, because people have rescheduled tons and tons of shows from over lockdown, and they've put them back on as soon as possible. So basically the next few months in any theatre or room or bar or anything is fucking jammed up with gigs already. So it is actually quite hard to get availability. Niall and yourself are in a Freaky Friday situation and have swapped bodies for a day. What's the first thing you do as the other person?
Jokes.
You would do jokes. I thought you were just so aggressive. Bang your wife. Immediately. I don't know.
I know. So,
there's a bar like the Stand Up. It's probably quite similar.
Yeah.
It's probably like making a coffee. Yeah. I don't know. Fuck me.
Yeah.
You wouldn't want to swap bodies with me. It's boring as shit and stressful and tired. Maybe you live in a nice place, don't you?
Yeah.
You know, fucking get a wee coffee, walk out the back. Play with your dog, you know?
Yeah, do that anyway.
Walk up a mountain. That's it. Would you rather back up... Oh, come on, man, this question. I've had this a million times. Would you rather back up an inch onto your da, or alternatively go forward 1 inch into your ma? Niall also included, please. What sort of orgy is this? I mean, it's fucking disgusting. My mom's dead, so good luck with that.
The
what's the best Alec Baldwin joke you've heard so far? It was just a meme, and it was like Alec Baldwin on the set of Rust or whatever the movie was called, and it was Jonah Hill in This Is the End. He's like bang 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 with the gun. I forgot to talk about that. That is bananas. Like,
it is.
Do you think there's something dodgy going on? Surely, like, who got shot in the past? Brandon Lee or something?
Yeah.
Oh. Or was it Bruce Lee? How did Bruce Lee die? Overdose?
I think so.
Some bullshit. So, I think it was Brandon Lee. He got shot with a gun or some. But then there was a bit of conspiracy around that. Like, was it a fucking plant, or did they do it deliberately, or any of that shit?
Yeah.
However, if that happened, if that was real or fake or whatever, surely surely it would be like, okay, we never have any sort of rounds in the, like, what, in this day and age, like, you don't actually need live gunfire noises.
No.
Because number one, it would be quite hard to capture, and it would fucking blow everything out anyway. It's so loud.
Yeah.
Second of all, you know, you can't really act around that. It would have to be like, and then afterwards it's like flashes and shit. Why the fuck was it like a real gun? Something's going on, man.
Yeah, there's a lot of shit going on about it.
Did you hear any? I haven't heard much, didn't read much into it, but like, have you heard any extra bits?
I heard a few things, but you always don't know, really.
What sort of things? Like, were they fucking...
They were saying like a lot of the crew had walked off earlier that day because they weren't getting paid. And then apparently that AD had been breaking loads of safety shit before when he got fired over it and everything on past jobs. So he's probably a bit of a nutter. But it's weird because Alec Baldwin will obviously get all the shit for it.
Yeah.
But it's not his fault at all.
I know, because even the post that he put up was very, like, diplomatic, kind of very sad about what happened to your woman today.
Yeah.
It wasn't him going, like, I'm gutted that I accidentally fired a weapon killing this woman by accident. It was all very, like, you know, apologies to anyone affected by this woman that got fucking murdered holding the camera. That's a rough day at the office.
It is. He'll probably never act again.
Think so?
I think that'll be him. Because the guy who shot Brandon Lee, he went mental or something. Like, he never acted again.
Was that an accident?
Yeah. Hmm. That was the crew or something. But that was the last time it happened.
Mm.
But it'll all come out eventually.
People love Alec Baldwin, though.
I know.
I'm a big fan.
The Team America.
Yeah. But like...
greatest actor of all time. Yeah.
But they do, though. You know, I feel like, you know, it's one of them things where, like, people would rally around him and be like, come on, man. This isn't your fault. Everyone loves you.
True.
Get back in there. How strange, though. That's fucked up. Have you ever seen Richard Pryor's son being booed off stage? Oh, didn't we? We had a son and you had a daughter who did stand-up, but this is going to be a Baroots McGoots. There's Paul Scholes sucking his daughter's toe. All right, then.
Noise for Mason Pryor.
And go.
Oh, God. Oh, is this... I hear, don't play this. Probably going to get fucking taken off.
He looked just like his daddy.
Hello.
Stop going.
Man, I'm nervous. I can literally hear my dad up in heaven right now, like, boy, you better not mess this up. A lot of crazy stuff going on right now. Donald Trump is president. Nah, calm down. I'm not as mad as Facebook is. You read the messages. Oh, Donald Trump, that's the worst president ever. Right now, you go get my Putin. Is that you, my Putin? I love you so much. I love the way you smell. I love the way your name comes off my lips. Boom.
Oh.
Sit down. Y'all not gonna move me. No, sit down.
Is that for real? Like, seems like some sort of setup.
Yeah.
Is that Richard Pryor's son? I mean, it's just reeks of a setup. Because it's like, come on, is fucking... Why would he be so like him? Doing stand-up, sounding like him, trying to look like him. Obviously, he's his dad, but it's like, that doesn't always happen. He's literally tried to, you know, dress older and fucking get the wee moustache and everything. I don't know. The comedy's not genetic, that's for sure. You can't pass it down. That's what happens. It's like... Richard Pryor lived this insane life, you know, growing up in a fucking brothel and all this shit and probably having to fucking keep himself safe with comedy. Cracking jokes. I don't fucking, you know, beat the shit out of me. And then his son grows up, probably loaded. You know, it's like a different, comfortable life. And then thinks you can just leap into stand-up. But anyway, I'm sweating after watching it. Down my shins. Suffered from the super cold too. What's your recommendation? Oh, fucking loads of questions about this. Mine is feeling sorry for myself and complaining. Yeah, that works too. When are you eventually going to get cancelled? What will it be for? I mean, take your fucking pick. Like, it just, you know what it is for me? When are they going to decide some of the things that I've said are inappropriate? That's what happens. It's like your jokes have a shelf life where you get away with them for a long time. I don't know. Like, you know, I don't say that bad of things, do you?
No.
I don't think I do. People think I'm all dirty. I'm dirty, for sure. I don't say that bad stuff. What's the strange, famous last words? You know what I mean? Tomorrow morning, Nolan.
This Colin Geddis problem.
What's the strangest coincidence you've experienced that you can't explain? Fuck. Well, the one that springs to mind of late was the whole t-shirt gate with fucking...
Oh, yeah. Seamus.
Seamus, the designer we're working with. And, you know, you fucking meeting William Mulhall wearing the same t-shirt or something.
Yeah.
And then years later, we're working with the designer who designed that fucking t-shirt. Oh, my God! Nuts. But I can't really... I'd need to think about any other coincidences. Might be in Dublin... Violin Mick, might be in Dublin for your gig at Whelan's. What's the name of the restaurant? McCann assumed every Chinese person in was working. I'd be needing a good feed at some point that night. Oh, man. It wasn't that great. It's not, it was just it was just that it was beside the fucking academy. That's all. It's the whatever, when you walk out of the academy and go left, it's the first Chinese restaurant you hit. And we were basically just holding the wall, trying not to fucking get swallowed up by the earth. Stoned. any idea what's going on in Tito Ortiz's head during the interview? There we go, some horse shit.
I'm an island boy.
You know, lastly, Chuck feels like he stole your thunder, and this is sour grapes from you. Like, it's personal because, in a way, you're jealous of him. How does hearing that out of his mouth fall on your ears?
Jealous of him? This guy can't even put a fucking sentence together, man. Are you kidding me right now? He's reaching for those grapes. He's trying to make his wine, and the wine's already sounding like a violin with that cheese and wine. We'll see you on November 24th.
Well, I mean, the guy asking the question wasn't really, you know, the most articulate guy of all time. But these are men that have been punched in the head.
You guys get older
consistently for a full career. So, if you were to fast forward 20 years, what legacy would you like to have left behind? Christ, I'm only 35, man. Old as shit, 35. Oh, fucking said it out loud there, and I threw up my mouth. If you were fast forward, what legacy would you leave? I mean, what age would it be? Fucking 55. I was gigging with comedians older than 55 at the weekend there. But then, would I want to be doing that when I'm 55? I doubt it. What sort of legacy? I have no idea. I mean, it's so wanky to make it up yourself, isn't it? I feel like someone else has to say it for you. But I actually really don't know. What would it be like? I don't know. It would be cool to be like one of those comedians. You know, where you're like, you'd be like, oh yeah, on a good night, he was fucking as good as anyone, type thing. Comedy wise, but I don't know. What did I read? Something like a legacy. Oh, where did I hear that? Where they were saying something like your legacy is like not what you did. It was like who you were. So, you know what I mean? It was like more like the type of person you were around loads and loads of people. That's your legacy rather than like your achievements type thing. So just trying to be a nice guy. You know what I'm saying?
Will you fuck up, Tate?
What's thoughts on Chappelle offering to sit down with the trans groups about what he said in his special? and news, and his doc isn't getting distributed due to the controversy. Oh, his doc isn't getting distributed. Now, speaking of guys who can't read, this guy. It's never going to happen, because when people get, when the real sort of woke brigade get pissed off, it goes in this vicious circle of going, you don't have the right to speak on that. I'm triggered. Don't speak about that. And then it's like, well, would you like to chat about it? And they're like, no, it's too traumatizing to fucking bring up the fact that I'm trans, even though it's my whole fucking identity in life. So it's probably never going to happen. And as he said in the thing, he goes, any trans people I know have no problem with what I've said. So it's like, where's the controversy come from? Bill Burr said that about something too. He's like, oh, you're getting cancelled. You have all this fucking controversy going about. He goes, who is it really? It could be fucking 10 people in the world, but it gets reshared by people with thousands and millions of followers. And he's like, in reality, you're still packing out rooms to people who want to listen to you. So I don't think anyone's ever going to sit down. I mean, he probably sat down with like Caitlyn Jenner and have a chat, and she'd be like, I have the right to cut off my penis, but also kill a woman and have nothing said about it, and also be against fucking gay marriage. You're like, Caitlyn, you're out of your mind. You mad bitch. You're like, you don't know what you want. Maybe you are a woman. I get cancelled over that.
Up the rod.
Honestly, I'll try not to do that as much from now on, but I'm absolutely having a field day today. Are you making Christmas dinner? If so, what are you having? Jesus! Will you have the UFC prelims on during your podcast? Fight Companion style, we're having a bit of a turbo wazzer for this gig. What time are you actually kicking off? The live podcast. Yeah, so it's going to go, it's very early. Doors are 6:30, show's at 7:30, and we might go from 7:30 straight through to 9:00, so Fight Companion style. You might get home for the prelims. I don't know what time they're on. Are you making Christmas dinner? I have made Christmas dinner the last few, because, you know, I'm not the most skillful cook of all time, but I have a good handle on timing, which is where the rest of the family fuck up. You know, they're a mess. They're like, oh God, I forgot to put this in. My technique now is, it's nearly all done the night before. And then it's just you prepare all the shit and then it just needs roasted. That sort of gear. So that's normally how we end up. We end up with like fucking 10 trays of stuff. Like, here's the sprouts with the bacon and the cranberry in it. Professional. You know, here's the fucking, the roasties. Sometimes I'll do a roast baby boil because I'm a fucking savage. You know, got the carrots on there. That's a must have. And then things like, sometimes you can just straight up cook the turkey crown the day before. Cut it into slices. Reheat the bitch. Ham will be done. It's all done the night before. But it's usually a turkey crown and then some of Maureen's ma's ham. Sounds gross. But I don't know what the fuck she does to it, but it's goddamn magical. It's more like pulled ham. It's not like slices of ham. It looks like pulled pork, but it's oh my God. I saw this and thought of you. What would you have your minions do to show their loyalty to you? North Korea soldiers show feats of strength. Flying headbutt to the concrete slab is sweet. Oh yeah, have you seen this?
Yeah.
North Koreans, man. I love how fucking, you know, they do these shows of strength and we got so much weaponry and we're so dangerous and meanwhile they're fucking eating grass. You know, we have no food. Don't know why that accent. What? Look at this guy. Boosh. North Korean soldiers. Oh, yeah. That's right. Kim Jong-un is fucking fuckboy city now. He lost a couple of pounds.
Boom.
He's feeling himself. Gangnam style. You know what I mean? Look at that. What the hell? Splat. Just hitting each other with planks. Boom. Right in the head. Look at him. He's just like, fucking, the fuck's going on in here? You mad bastards. You know, we're supposed to have fucking nuclear weapons of mass destruction. They're like, nah, I've got four dudes with a plank here. You watch yourself, man. This motherfucker's been to home base. Just wrecking bricks. Oh, man. I like the Korean style of clapping non-stop. I wonder, could I get that at a show? Guys, do some Korean clapping for the next 45 minutes. Punch. Yes. Someone doesn't have a roof. Yes. Roof tiles. Fucked. Oh, what are they doing here? Gonna bend this stick with their throats? Oh, he's gonna burst out of a chain. Oh, he did it! Yeah! It seemed Mr. Kim, what? Came in his pants? I love that. 14 soldiers were killed by smacking each other with 4x4s. It seemed to please Mr. Kim. Full fucking exhibition of smashing up the contents of a home base. And he's like, it seemed to please me. Smile. It is funny that he was getting so much stick for being a fat cunt though, and now he's lost a bit of weight. He's relaxed the haircut a bit too, you know, the fade isn't as tight.
Yeah.
And it went global. That's his biggest dominant force on earth. Lads going into fucking barbers on Botanic being like, "Give the fucking Kim Jong." What do you mean? Big fade up the side, bro. Going to Thompson's tonight. I seem to be pleased. That had Korean language though. Crazy. Isn't it? Squid Games?
Yeah.
How many questions have we got left here? Fucking loads! Let me see what we got. What are you going to spend your £100 on? Bro, I haven't even registered for it. Did you register for yours?
Yeah.
I don't know how to. There was something to do with letters going to like my fucking dad's house still for some... I don't know what the fucking crack was. He goes, I have your letter here. And I was like, what? I haven't lived there in fucking... years, like, but anyway, I need to speak to him. What are you gonna spend your? I went ham in town and couldn't recommend the wee Vietnamese coffee shop enough. What are you gonna spend? Have you to take it into a local shop? Is that the deal?
Yeah.
Where are you taking yours?
I just bought lots of brunch.
Did you?
The whole thing was on food.
How many goes? Many goes did you get at it?
4. Went to Birch in Newcastle.
Oh, new, is it?
Yeah.
Nice. New,
and the pocket. A few times, and then Birch again. That's pretty much it.
Fuck yeah, I don't have mine. Fuck!
It's handy.
Oh, fuck.
Handy for the brunch.
I get one. Hey Colin, Ticketmaster useless. Had asked about a possible refund, but now can fly back in for a gig. All tickets are still valid from September unless... But back up for resale by buyer. You're not aware of them refunding it. Bro, I don't know what the fuck any of that means. I have no idea. You're not aware of them refunding or cancelling tickets? I have no idea. You seriously need to fucking... It's like so out of my hands. I have no idea. Because I know the resale thing was like you can put it up for resale and if someone buys it, then they get the new ticket sent out to them or something. I don't know. Would you ever consider doing a show in Edinburgh? Yeah, I would. So there. Thoughts on Insulate Britain? Do you know what that is about?
They're a wee bit like hippies.
Okay.
Trying to make a change for the environment. But it's not like, you know, they're not hippies. They're like doctors and everything. And they're just being like, you know, there's no...
The environmental activist group has resumed its series of roadblock protests. So that's it. A series of protests by the group Insulate Britain involving traffic obstruction began on 13th of September. The group has blockaded the M25 and other motorways. What are they trying to say?
They're trying to get attention from the government to make it to be more environmentally friendly, basically.
All right. Well, you're going to get killed.
I know.
I think when there are people are doing protests like that and stuff, do it to the fucking
government.
Government.
I know.
You're getting, like, they were talking to, like, regular people, and the guy was like, yeah, I've fucking driven the whole way here and hired this thing or whatever to do a job interview, and I can't get to it now.
Yeah.
You know, it's things like that where you're like, you fucking asshole. I hate any sort of disruption in a selfish way. You know, even like fucking, even in this fucking country, any sort of parades or marches or even pride or any of them fucking things, you're like, do it in the park, you dickhead.
I know.
Why have we the fucking, like, oh, it's today, so we can't do anything?
Will you fuck up, dude?
Get in a park somewhere and have a fucking field day, literally. Enjoy yourself. Instead of being like, oh yeah, you can't go into town between these times because it's fucking assless chaps. Guy playing a fucking flute. Do it in a field. Have you ever thought of having a successful local chef on the podcast? Not that cunt Rankin. I had Rankin in next week. I had fucking Paul Rankin and Dean Deans. What's his name again? What is his name? Of Deans. What the fuck's the dude's name? Can't remember now. Both were assholes to work for. I'd recommend Andy Ray, the owner of Mourn Seafood. He's got great stories. He's very funny and good to work for. All right, Marco's got a fucking dog in this race here.
Marco Pierre White.
and that is from Marco Pierre White. Have you ever, not that cunt Rankin. Fuck sick. Oh, God. Let me see. Happy belated. What does that say? It's coming up to Halloween, so perfect time to play a bit of old Audio Picnic Halloween special episode. I don't even know what that is. Last few months for yourself. Any chance you could get some of the old co-hosts on as guests? Categorically, no. Because Richard Crothers, I think, lives in Canada. Rocky used to go out with, you know, Maureen's sister, so we don't speak to him. And Dan Watson. That ain't happening. So, you're stuck with me. Imagine they all started a podcast themselves again. Fraudio Picnic. Happy belated birthday. Thanks, man. What's the worst, best Halloween costume you've ever rocked? I mean, I probably mentioned this before. I had a Jason outfit that was so terrifyingly realistic that people were like stepping out of my way in the bar. Because it was like, I really committed to it. It was like a lot of, it just looked very realistic, and it was covered in like dirt and muck and blood and fucking had a real machete. That probably had something to do with it. That was pretty good. Worst, I mean, we've talked about this before. This was literally a clip from a podcast where my ma sent me into school dressed as a tramp, which you couldn't get away with. You couldn't even, you know, even if you used more politically correct terminology, you couldn't be like, what are you today, Colin? I'm a homeless. Fantastic. Everyone's dressed as fucking Squid Games and Bane and whatnot. I'm a tramp. The best one, I mean, it's fucking hectic, but the most controversial ones, which are the ones where you're like, oh, that's too soon. So like Steve Irwin died, and then some guy was in a nightclub in the fucking khaki shorts and everything, with the hat with the corks on it, and then a fucking toy stingray like sticking out of his chest. You're like, oh man, that is fucking genius and brutal also. Let me see, I'll go back to that. This is our last thing. You may wish to react to this abomination. Let's see, man. It's better be racist. Oh, wait. Oh, yeah.
Days are like that, me and you back to back, loving it, you know that. Kissing, chatting, loving, reminiscing, thinking the birds missing. It was great.
Does he look like John Cena, or am I going nuts?
Love creating. Should have made a baby. Loving it. It was lovely. Like
he literally sounded like, do you remember that wee girl eating a bit of toast in the car?
Yeah, is it nice? She goes, it's lovely. We had a wife making love. It was lovely.
Oh shit, what happened there?
Get in.
Oh, what happened? I lost it. Let me hear the rest of this fucking savage beat. Just white guys rapping. Go home.
Love rap. Days are like that. Me and you back to back. Loving it, you know that. Kissing, chatting, loving, reminiscing. Thinking the birds missing. It was great. Love creating. Should have made a baby. Loving it. It was lovely. Micah, to the three, to the four.
Five.
I want you to keep coming back for more.
Five.
Shagging, knocking on my door. Yes, chatting, six. Chilling. Let's get in the bedroom, let's start fucking. Seven. Amy, Chelsea, Rosa, Mesa, the ladies, was lovely. Kirsten, in the club, in the pub. Dick touching, rub, groping.
Why do I keep losing that? That guy's just reminiscing about the fucking three times that you hooked up with chicks.
Chelsea, Mercy, lovely, in the pub, dick rub.
And then, of course, I went to jail for a while. No sex since then. Kill myself. Nightmare. Not very lovely. Sad. Now, what's the Rocks rap song? We'll finish on this. This is the worst. The rock rap song. Oh, nearly spelled some of that right. Cool. No, I'm definitely going to get taken off the internet for this. Have you heard this?
No.
Dwayne The Rock Johnson.
Fresh.
He goes from Lawnscapes by Mike. What the fuck is he? What are these ads, man? Get out of my life. Don't play this video at all. We're going to get taken off.
Yeah.
I'll get to the...
Let's give...
Some... Oh, came in my pants.
Fuck shit up.
Oh, he's gonna fuck shit up. Dwayne The Rock Johnson, how can you be like that big, that famous, jacked, cringy, weirdly enough, like not sexy? Like no one's like, oh my God, I fancy The Rock. And just a fucking total D-bag, but the most famous guy in the world. Let me see. That's not him. That's not him. That's not him. Okay. Did they save him for the end like he's Jay-Z? Who's that?
Based off the description I gave, cut the game off.
Bad. Twisted. Wait. Bad. Come on.
Leave a nigga humble like them.
Oh, here he comes.
Take your face off. They gon' rumble. They gon' take your face off. They gon' rumble.
Devour. Put in the work. Put in the hours and take what's ours. Like in some morning, my veins, my culture banging with strange. I change the game, so what's my motherfucking name?
Dwayne.
Get the desecration.
Donation.
If you want to bring it to the masses, face to face, now we escalating. When I have to put boost the asses, mean on ya. Like a dream when I'm rumbling, you're gonna scream, mama. So bring drama to the king, Brahma. Fight it to an extreme mana.
Wow.
That is hectic, isn't it?
Hectic.
I'm rapping about stuff, but kind of not cursing. Let's fuck shit up. It's just... There's been a lot of bad... Do you know what's better than that? The fucking Island Boy?
Island Boy.
I don't even know where to go from that. I mean, 10 million hits, that has sapped the life out of me. I mean, he's got traps for days, but he's got traps for days, does not have raps for days.
Nope.
That's for damn sure. You know? Anyway, we're going to get the fuck out of here. That must be an hour and a half now, is it?
It is.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Right,
what did I say to you before this? We'll be a couple of fucking... what is this? It's like, we'll be a couple of minutes. Oh, fuck me. Right, we'll get out of here. Shout out to Flow CBD LTD as well. They sponsor the podcast. Go over there for all your CBD needs. I don't know if there's a promo code at the minute because someone said they tried to use it. It doesn't matter. If you're getting your CBD products, go over there. They got the fucking, they got the bath bombs, they got gummies, they got everything, man. FlowCBDLTD.com, the OGs. One more time.
Up the rod.
We're out of here. See you later.